G'day and welcome. Welcome to Qigong Live Online. Today, this is the beginner's class, so I've got some new people there, so welcome to the class. Good to see you, eh? So far in the beginner's series, we've done the warming up exercises, we've done the breathing, and we've done the stances. Today, we're going to do the gong, which is like a formal way to start classes. And because I teach from a monastery school teaching, it's formal, and so they have a formal bow. And I'm going to teach you the bow today, because doing these exercises, when I do them from now on, I'll always bow at the start of the class and I'll bow at the end of the class. So I'm going to teach you how to do the bow. So this is the next one is the bow situation. After we do the bow, the next one we have to do the bow, we're going to talk about movements. Now we might do the bow and we might do some of the movements, because there's three ways we move, and I don't want to put too much in one lesson, so I'm keep it nice and simple. But the next one we're going to do talk about how we move from side to side, the next class, and then how we do rotations and how we go down to give us up, and that's what we're going to do in the next class. But we're going to do the bow today. So the bow is important. The bow is about putting your mind in its rightful place, putting your consciousness in a place before you practice, so that you let go all that's happened outside of your life and come back to being present in the present moment. It's really important. So we'll talk a little bit about that. So first of all, we're going to stand with our feet. We'll do our feet first. So our feet, our toes face off towards the 10 and 2. So we've got the 10 and 2 feet. Well, actually, it'll be, if you think of 12 o'clock in this front and 9 o'clock's one side and 3 o'clock's the other, will be a little bit different for you. But think of when you're looking at me, you can see the 12, 9 and 3. Well, it's going to be 10:30 and 1:30. The feet are facing those directions. Yep. Now, there's a two-finger gap, two of your finger gap between your heels. So you put it between your heels and the gap's between your heels. Now, this gap's actually quite precise because of the energy goes between. It's like a spark gap, like in a car when you spark plug. That spark gap is very precise. Well, it is in our body as well. And the energy travels between the heels. Yep. So then we start with that and we put our weight on the front part of our feet, our kidney points. Now our heels are touching the ground, but there's no weight in the heels. So you're standing on your muscles and bend your knees slightly to do that. Makes it easier, otherwise you lean forward. So bend your knees slightly, standing on the kidney points, kidney one point. Remember, kidney one point is in the bottom of your foot, between the pads. Just have the two pads, and it's right in the middle between the two pads, just there. And I'm going to be standing on that point. I'm standing on that point. Now your toes are touching the ground, your kidney point's touching the ground, and your heels are just resting on the ground, but there's no weight. I'm actually sprung. I'm standing on my muscles. And by doing that, by bending my knees, I stand on my muscles, because what you don't want to do is rock back and stand on your heels. We've talked about in the stances about the same principle. So come forward, kidney points. Now grasp your toes into the ground, and we're standing in this point with our feet 10 to 2. You can grasp your toes and then relax your toes and stand on the kidney points. Very good. Their hands are on the side of the body, remember the knees slightly bent. Now when we're in this posture, I'll just stand to the side so you can see that, you want to tuck your bottom forward and then relax. So you tuck your bum underneath and relax. You tilt your pelvis and relax. And so it's really important that when we do the tilt, when we go forward with the hips, that you don't hold the pressure there, that you actually relax after you hold it. But don't relax and let it go back to where it was. Tuck it forward and then relax straight down. Good. Perfect. So we've got that part. Now, tuck your pelvis, relax. Hands are on the side of your body. And this is the dragon's mouth. It's the thumb. This is the large intestine meridian and the lung meridian, if you want to know the meridians. And it's on the side of the body like that. So your thumb's facing towards the back, and your index finger's facing down your leg, both sides, yeah? Now this is the gallbladder meridian on the side of your leg, and it's sitting right in the middle of the gallbladder meridian, both your fingers, both sides, yeah? And from that posture, you're going to roll back onto your thumbs. You're going to let the large intestine meridian go and just roll back onto your thumbs that way. I'll go around the front so you can see that. From there, I roll back onto my thumbs. Now, my thumbs are still touching my legs. You take away your fingers and your thumbs still touching. Now, from this position, if I just relax my shoulders, the arms just come forward by themselves. Yeah. So I'll go back to that. Dragon's mouth. Roll back onto the thumbs. Relax your arms, and they come forward by themselves. So we're going to use this momentum of the arms coming forward, and we're going to use that momentum to bring your hands around, and the left hand goes underneath and the right hand goes on top. Now the finger joints, it's the second joint back on your finger and the second joint back on this one, they overlap each other. Hopefully you can see that. The two joints are together. Yep. And so we sit doing, and so this is a yang surface, a yin surface, and this is a yang surface. So they've got a yin and yang together. The two creases follow each other, and then we connect the two thumbs, and you're trying to have as a round a circle as you can. It won't be perfectly round, but as round as you can. You don't want it like that. You don't want your fingers crossed. You want it sitting like that. And the two joints, you can see where the two knuckle joints are overlapping each other. Same knuckle joints, the second one back to there like that. Yin and yang together. And when you hold the position like this, don't have the elbows out to the side and don't have them crushed inside each other. You want them hanging just so there's a hollow underneath your armpits to hold the arms there. So you hold the two things, fingers like that. Very good. Now the space from your tummy is about one palm of your hand out from your tummy. I'll turn around so you can see that. So that's not, they're not touching your stomach. They're out from there about 1 foot out from your lower dantian. Remember your lower dantian is underneath your navel, underneath your tummy button, about three fingers underneath your tummy button. There's a point in the under those three points. And that's the front drawer of your dantian, your lower dantian. And the dantian is like an energy center, and it's halfway between the front and the back. We've actually got a front door and back door, and acupuncture points for both of them. And it's right in the middle of your body, and there's a front door and a back door of that point. When we've got our hands to the front, my hands, the hole, this hole, is right where that point is. So the point's actually pointing out through the hole, that way. Yep. Relax the arms. Don't relax your arms, shoulders, just let your arms so this feels like there's hollow armpits. Yeah? Good. Remember, we tucked our pelvis, standing on the kidney points, and that posture there. Very good. Now, if I change it to show you what it is, what's actually happening energetically, it's like a figure eight. And so I'm standing here this bit, but I've put my hands up like that so you can see it. It's going down the arm, through my lower dantian, through my physical center, down the legs, through the heels, up the other side, and it's doing this figure eight thing, going through the body. And we create this infinity energetic circle happening inside the body while we're standing there. But because it's not easy to stand like that, we stand like this, but the energy is still doing exactly the same thing through the figure eight, through the lower dantian. Very good. Stand there like that. And then gong. Gong means bow. And when you say gong, then you let the arms come up, you make a fist with your left hand. Now the whole of your left hand's up that way. You don't make a fist this way, you hold the hole in the top that way. And then you bring your right hand around and it covers around the hand. And then you bring your thumb across the top. Yes, it looks like that. It comes across the top. The hands come around, covers the fist, thumb over the top. So you end up with like that. Very good. So we start from there. We roll back. Left hand underneath, right hand on top, two thumbs together. Gong. Make a fist with your left hand, cover it with your right. So you're holding that posture. Now, when we hold your arms, the arms aren't straight. Yeah, the arms have got a slight bend in them. I'll go to the side so you can see that. It's not straight like that. The arms have got a bend that way. The fist is in front of your heart, so you're holding your hands in front of your heart. Yep. When we do that and you make the fist, you look down, you lower your head, and you look through the gap that you're between your arms, funny place for your legs, between your arms, you look between your arms and look down towards the ground, yeah? Then you bring your head back up again, and as you bring your head back up, you open your hands. So now both palms are open, facing towards yourself, and you bring the energy into your heart. Bring it back towards your heart. And the remaining energy you bring back to your lower dantian, you push it down, back to your lower dantian, your physical center. We talked about this before, about this is your mental center in your mind, your spiritual center in your heart, your physical center in your lower dantian. These are the upper, middle, and lower dantians, yeah? And so we do that. Yeah, we'll do that again, eh? So we start from the side. Remember, we'll go through the different parts. 10 to 2 stance, 2-finger gap. Weight on the kidney points, bend your knees. Tuck your pelvis back. Good. Hold here. Bring your chin back as well. Stand there on the side. Remember, the dragon's mouth is on the side of your body, fingers touching, thumbs pointing backwards. Roll back on your thumbs. And then bring your left hand underneath, right hand on top. Two thumbs together. And this is the same for males and females. The same right hand over the top of the left. And gong. Make a fist with your left hand, cover it with your right. Good. Look, put your head down. Look between the hole. Then look at your, bring your head back up again. Open your hands. Bring the energy of the center back into your heart. And then back down to your lower dantian. Good. And then you move to the side, back into the horse stance. Yep. Back into the stance. There you go. We'll do it one more time, eh? Have a practice. So we do it, and normally I'll do this at the start of the class. Now I'll explain a little bit about what's actually the spiritual understanding, or the understanding of why we do that. We'll just go and practice it again. 10 to 2, kidney points, bend your knees, tuck your pelvis. Good. Roll your hands back onto your thumbs. Left hand underneath, right hand on top, two thumbs together. Gong. Make a fist with your left hand, cover it with your right. Open, put your head down, look between your hands, then bring your hand back up again. Open your hands, bring them towards your heart, and then bring the remaining energy back to your lower dantian. Good. And then we move into horse stance and we start our exercises. And that's how we start. So a little bit behind, the sign, the gong is a sign of respect, but it's a sign of respect for not only yourself and other people, but also your respect for nature, respect for the planet we live on, respect for all the animals and all the human beings on the planet. We're giving respect for all of that, all the life that's on this planet. And the grass is alive, everything's alive. So we're giving respect for being in a human, in a physical body, in a biological body, and our soul that lives inside our body, which our body carries us around, our soul around, and we're giving thanks for having this experience in this physical body in this world. And so part of the gong is for that acknowledgement and the humbleness and the reverence for having this experience in life. Yeah. And I know some people's lives aren't the best life in the world, and some people are born into a lot of hardship, but we can change our lives. There's a way we can change it in our mind, and we can get out of these places we get caught sometimes. So the bow is understanding that we're part of a bigger picture, and that we can change the way we think, and we're giving thanks to the fact that we're alive on this planet, and what can we do on this planet? We can make a difference to ourselves and people around us. Yeah. Okay. So have a good day. We're going to bow on the way out. So we'll say goodbye and we'll bow on the way out. Another practice. And if you have any questions about, just message me in the questions and I'll answer your questions about it. Very cool. There's lots more to it. And when we do philosophy classes, when you do the advanced classes, it'll come up in the advanced classes. We'll come and do a course with me sometime. Go and do an online course, a live course. We talk a lot more about it. But it's a nice place to start it. And it puts your mind and your heart in a good place before you start practicing, which is always a good thing. Roll back onto your thumbs. Left hand underneath, right hand on top, two thumbs together. Gong. Make a fist with your left hand, cover it with your right. Bring towards your heart, down to your physical center. Very good. And we're going to step back, and we're going to bow to everybody that's watching this class, and everybody that's going to come and do this class later. Just bow to you, and have a beautiful day, everybody, eh? Bye-bye.